Today's second mark of beauty is the snug fit, made possible by the yarns. Yuki City, located roughly 80 kilometers from Tokyo, produces a distinctive style of the tsumugi. Even to this day, Yuki Tsumugi wholesale shops line the streets. This shop has been operating for 180 years. It has inherited a splendid tsumugi that has been nurtured over time.
My great-grandfather wore this piece. It's probably extremely soft by now. A newly made piece would be a bit tougher than this. The Yuki Tsumugi was what the common folk wore. It is silk, but made to look like cotton. It's a mat tsumugi.
The Yuki Tsumugi is made to look as though it were woven with cotton. A tsumugi fresh off the loom was not viewed as being a silk kimono, for it was hard and rigid. A tsumugi starts out hard and gradually becomes softer. A special type of yarn called tsumugi yarn is used to weave it. The yarn is thick and fluffy. The vertical yarns are tied onto the hip of the weaver so that she can use her whole body to adjust the tightness of the weave. As the tsumugi yarn is durable and elastic, it must be firmly woven into position for the final product to be good.
I'm hitting it in, but the yarn won't fit. That's why I really try to strike it in there. But sometimes, it just won't go in.
It is this hard-to-manage yarn that, with time, gives the tsumugi wearer superb comfort. The tsumugi was originally made by silkworm farmers for their own clothing, using inferior silk cocoons unsuited for sale. Cocoons that were dirty or tangled, therefore unsuited for use as yarn, were considered to be of inferior quality. The tangled cocoon is first spread out by hand into a fluffy bulk. From there, the fibers are pulled out. When saliva is rubbed into the fiber, it forms a strand of tsumugi yarn.
The saliva acts as glue. It is formed into shape with saliva. So it's not a twined yarn.
Because the fibers drawn out from the fluff are not even in thickness nor in length, it is difficult to twine them into shape. A twined silk yarn is glossy and smooth. On the other hand, the tsumugi yarn is thick and fluffy. Let's take a microscopic view of the tsumugi yarn. Large gaps are seen between fibers. When compared to silk yarn, we see that the fibers of the tsumugi yarn are not tightly together.
Usually, fibers are twined to form a yarn. These fibers are pulled out by hand and given a little twist. They are not twined, as the fibers are not pulled out with much force. They stray in all different directions. Because it is not twined, the yarn is very weak. It needs glue to compensate for the lack of twining. Otherwise, it cannot be used to weave with.
The tsumugi yarn is dipped in glue to enhance its durability. Instead of twining, the tsumugi yarn is strengthened with saliva and glue. This method plays a key role in creating the extreme comfort that the final product will offer with time.
It's really a hard-to-handle yarn. The object of this process is to use glue to make it easier to handle this hard-to-manage tsumugi yarn.
After being soaked in glue, the yarn is washed repeatedly. This process softens the yarn.
In time, the yarns become fluffy again. They go back to the fluffy state. Because the yarn isn't twined, the fibers eventually come undone. The more one wears it, the more its strings come undone and become tangled. This creates the nice texture of the yuki tsumugi.
The more it is worn, the more it becomes comfortable to wear. It's the painstaking craftsmanship of silkworm farmers that transformed inferior cocoons into comfortable wear.
My great-grandfather, Rohan, loved the tsumugis worn by the merchants, who would often come to his house.
So he wanted the merchants' work clothes?
Exactly. I think he was fascinated with the aura given off by tsumugi worn over time.
Aura given off by tsumugi.
Lastly, let's look at how the tsumugi can be worn like no other kimono. Among admirers of tsumugi today, the trend is to re-tailor old tsumugis. Such tsumugis are known as remade tsumugis. Tsumugis of different colors are patched together. Tsumugis of different patterns are also patched together. Some even feature patches from dyed kimonos.
Originally, this tsumugi had no design. But by adding these patches, the piece becomes more feminine. The tsumugi is great because it can be enjoyed in its plain form, but it can be made more fun by adding colors to it. This can be done only because the tsumugi is casual wear. Originally, it was not to be worn to formal occasions. That's why you can be playful and have fun with it.
By adding various colors to a tsumugi. You can give it a completely new appeal. Today's final mark of beauty is add colors and savor the elegance. Mari Ishijima has long studied the tsumugi. Ishijima explains that the tsumugi's appeal lies in the beauty of its fabric, a product of painstaking craftsmanship. The skillful use of colors is a way to further heighten the allure of the fabric.
These tsumugis were made in Yuki City. All of them feature playful use of color on the hakake.
The coloring of the hakake, or the lining of these kimonos, work to complement the elegance of the tsumugi.
The outer fabric of a tsumugi is mostly low-keyed. That makes more room for playfulness on the lining.
Tsumugis with low-keyed linings are also popular now. This one, for example, is black on both sides. A tsumugi like this leaves room for the wearer to experiment with the color of the obi, or sash.
The black on both sides makes you forget that it's a kimono. A lot of people say that it feels like wearing a set of Western clothes. There's a lot of fun you could have with the color of the obi or sash.
This tsumugi is black with tortoiseshell patterns on it. When a brown obi is worn around it, the outfit in its entirety becomes perfect for fun occasions. With an obi dyed with colors extracted from plants, the outfit becomes perfect for work. The tsumugi can match many occasions depending on the obi.
The tsumugi fabric allows a lot of room for one to be adventurous with the obi she chooses to wear.
Some express their way of life through the tsumugi. Essayist Masako Shirasu always reviewed Buddha statues and other antiques with a unique sense of beauty. She too passionately loved the tsumugi. In 1973, Shirasu went to receive a literary prize dressed in a tsumugi, despite the fact that wearing a tsumugi to such an occasion was considered taboo. She deliberately attended the ceremony in her tsumugi, wearing this gold and silver obi.
Firstly, its color is modern. It's still modern today. An ordinary person would wear an obi of contrasting color, like red, yellow, colors like that. I like this. I think this is appropriate. I'm not afraid to break the norm. I think these are the thoughts she had when wearing this to the ceremony.
By adding gold and silver, Shirasu had turned her tsumugi into a festive kimono. When coupled with the bold ideas of those who wear it, the tsumugi becomes a kimono with infinite possibilities.
Talking with you made me remember that in the closet I had a tsumugi my grandfather used to wear. This is a tsumugi now, is it not?
It certainly is.
Putting it on brought back memories of my grandfather. I like the idea of wearing the family history.
Yes, it's a warm feeling.
What do you say the three of us go out together in tsumugis?
Great.
Hey, let's go already.
Be right there.
She always does this when we're about to leave. She takes so much time. And then we have an argument. We do it all the time. But I guess it takes time to put on a kimono. I can't wait to go.